Can you hear the dogs barking? Am I supposed to say like, hello, Sarah here? That's so awkward. But like, Zuko, guys, Zuko, like, I don't know. Is there like a pop? I don't know. He's cute, right? Like, come on. Come on. Like, I feel like anyone who's watched Avatar, they know Zuko is like a great character and also pretty cute in season 3, you know? Wait, you know what I mean? Like, with the hair. With the... This is not something I normally do. I don't really usually film myself doing my bullet journal or anything like that because it usually takes me forever. And I didn't think that, I don't know, it was like very, I don't know if practical is the right word, but like, I just feel like it would take me a long, or like, it'd be very long to film like all that I go through, because it's actually not that much after I got famous. And like, yeah, but usually I like to take my time. And when I say take my time, I mean like, I take a lot of breaks and I take several days to do it all. But I tried my best to sketch out. Well, you guys will see. Oh, so if you don't know what a bullet journal is, how about we Google the definition. With that definition, yeah, I don't know. I basically just explain it as like, it's a planner or an agenda that I kind of make myself. Like, yeah, make for myself. And it's kind of like personalized to how I want it to be and how I want it to look. So, for this month, that's what I'm showing you guys. Or like, for, yeah. Yeah, because I do like, it's like a monthly type of thing. But, yeah, I think that's all. So, let's go. Okay, guys, so I already sketched out what I wanted on my layouts this month, because I usually like to sketch things out that I am planning to outline, because I'm not very confident in just going in with freehand, and I didn't want to, like, you know, waste your guys' time filming me sketching and then just going over again with pen. So here we are. If you guys can guess, this month's theme is Sailor Moon, and it wasn't my first idea to do Sailor Moon. I was kind of thinking about doing Avatar at first, but then the more I thought about it, the more complex it got. So I was talking to my sister and she brought up Sailor Moon because July is, half of it I think is Cancer season, and Sailor Moon, or Usagi, happens to be Cancer. So, fun fact, Cancers are, I think, known for being kind of emotional, and you can really see that in Usagi in the show, because she cries all the time and is like always being called a crybaby. But like, I kind of relate, because I'm not a Cancer, but I feel like my family and friends know that I'm like, I cry a lot because I'm sensitive, so it's okay, I don't judge her. So after I was finished outlining, I decided to color it in with my Twistables and color pencils. Actually, color pencils aren't my favorite way of, I guess, adding color to a page, because I really don't like the way I color. Like, it just does not turn out the way, or I just don't think it looks that nice. But I didn't think going over it with like markers or anything would be that nice either, so I guess this was like the less of two evils, or whatever. It just, I mean, in the end it didn't turn out so bad, so I don't mind. I do like the right side of the cover page more than the left side, but it's okay. I just think that the picture turned out better. And because Usagi and her friends are still students, I kind of wanted to incorporate that somehow. So using a gray marker, I just made the background seem as if though it was binder paper, because when you're in school, you take a lot of notes on binder paper. And I feel like when you're bored or like you're kind of just like messing around, you kind of draw and like doodle. Moving on to my calendar layout, I tried to add to like the student life type of theme by drawing a few items you might see on a student's desk. I drew like a pair of glasses and a pen just to like make it seem like, oh, things are like kind of scattered over your desk. And actually the pen is like from the show, but like they don't actually use it as a pen. It's actually it's called a disguise pen or something, and it helps them turn into or like transform into whatever they need. They just need to say like moon power blank blank blank, and then they turn into whatever they want or need to. But for the calendar itself, I was inspired actually by another bullet journaler, Amanda Rachel Lee, who you guys should really check out if you want to see like a real like professional bullet journaler. She's really cool, and I feel like her layouts are always very aesthetic and very nice to watch. Even like when I'm not bullet journaling, I just like to watch her videos because it's so like nice to see someone just put things together so like aesthetically. It's just so pleasing to the eyes. And I was inspired from her June 2019 spread, where she did like a milk tea type thing, which I love milk tea. So, and for the calendar, I picked a couple colors I thought were very Sailor Moon-esque, because I really love when like colors come together and they just look really nice together, like a palette of colors. So I kind of went with, you know, pink, yellow. I think that is really Sailor Moon-y, I guess, in a lack of better words. Also, I kind of went again with the whole binder paper type thing, but I did it horizontally this time because I thought putting two vertical ones next to each other when it's one calendar would be weird. And then on the right side, I left a space or like a column for notes, because sometimes I just need to remind myself of important things that are happening this month. Because during the summer, I don't do weekly spreads, like separate weekly spreads, because I realized I don't really put anything in there because nothing really occupies my time. So it's actually nice because it's quicker for me to like do the whole month. I don't really need to do the weekly spreads. Also, kind of random, I actually have not watched all of Sailor Moon, but I'm trying to because I do have time now, and I was watching a couple of the episodes, and I noticed that like every single time Sailor Moon gets into a fight and then she's like in danger and like she's like knocked down and she's like sad, like Tuxedo Mask swoops in and freaking throws a rose. It lands like maybe right in front of the enemy and like something happens, but then all of a sudden he's like, okay, you can handle it now, I'm gotta go, and then he just leaves, and I'm like, oh, okay, that's great. I mean, she does end up defeating the enemy on her own anyways. So for my last two pages, I did a habit tracker and a mood tracker, and for the habit tracker, I made 6 mini calendars, which are also inspired from Amanda Rachel Lee. I track things like how many times a month I get milk tea, because guys, I really have a problem, like I'm like low-key addicted, so I kind of track it to see if it'll make me feel bad. But usually it doesn't really. Anyway, so I guess I don't know how helpful it is, but I mean, it's nice to know how many times a month I spend money on milk tea. But actually, who am I kidding, I'm not the one who pays for it. Yeah, I also track things like how many times a month I study. Even though it's summer, I'm trying to like pick up a new language, but out of the how many lessons are for that language, I have only gone through 5, which is so me. Anyways, I wanted to add like a couple doodles to the page just to like make it more interesting. So I drew I saw on Pinterest like this minimalistic, they literally use the word minimalistic, sun and moon type drawings, and I thought it was pretty like fitting for Sailor Moon, because I think in the theme song there's something about like fighting evil by moonlight and winning love by daylight. I thought it just, you know, related. Now that I think about it, that kind of is really cheesy. I mean, like, in a cute way, I guess. But that's really cheesy. For my mood tracker this month, I wanted to still play on the doodle idea. So I had a doodle represent each day of the month. And to still keep with the theme of Sailor Moon, I had each doodle be related to the show. So I drew things like the sailor bows that you see on the girls' outfits, which I think are really cute. And I drew like simple stars or moons. And I also added a few of the weapons and tools that the girls are given to defeat the bad guys. And I also wanted to incorporate Luna and Artemis, which are the cats in the show that are like advisors to the girls, because I think they know a lot more about the villains and about like the whole like magic power like moon type stuff than the girls do, because the girls are just like humans and they're just students and they don't really know much. So I think Luna and Artemis are very helpful to them and they guide them a lot in the show. So typically I have a designated color for each month, but for the past couple months I've been using a range of colors for each setup, similar to this month how I used the hot pink, the baby pink, the gray, the yellow, and the purple. So to kind of incorporate that into my mood tracker, I had each color represent a mood on a range from really happy to really sad. And with that, we're pretty much done. So I'll show you guys a quick flip through of the final look.
Okay, wait, stop. I don't know what I'm saying.
So guys, after today I've learned, maybe I should record when almost no one is home except my sister, because it is freaking loud. And
anyways, sorry, that was totally like random and like off topic. I sometimes do that. I'm like, yeah, I procrastinated a lot this month, I feel like. But it is summer, so what am I supposed to I don't know. I don't need to defend myself. Oh my gosh, if you got to this point and you actually dealt with me for like, I don't know how long, like around 15 minutes probably, like, oh, thanks. Dude, you're awesome. Awesome. Like, thank you. I don't know. Like, what do you even get from this? If you watch this, you probably know me. And probably means you probably... I can't even talk. You probably talk to me on a regular basis. So, you didn't really need to watch this video, because you could have just talked to me. But thanks for watching. Like, I really appreciate that. Like, honestly. Even though it's just... Yeah, anyways, just, yeah, I don't really know. Huh, I wonder if it's like a cute thing to say, or like, that's not awkward for me, because I feel like I don't, like, all I would be is like, bye. That, like, I feel like awkward saying that as my intro, but like, let's say that was my intro, like, would my outro be like, something opposite? Like, bye, Sarah out.
Maybe I should just give up. I don't know.